Well, surprise, surprise, today more developments on the recurring asylum seeker issue. First, a 40-year-old alleged people smuggler was arrested in Sydney and charged over the Christmas Island tragedy that killed more than 40 people last December. At the same time, the Gillard government's hopes of shipping refugees off to Malaysia appears to be getting more difficult, literally by the day. Hamish McDonald joins us from Kuala Lumpur. Hamish, it would appear that you've actually got another tasty morsel that could upset the Gillard government's swap plan, if you like, even further.
Yeah, there are serious questions about this whole strategy now, George. The development today, an article written for the Star newspaper by a senior former diplomat raises the question about whether this is in fact legal under Malaysian law. It's significant because that newspaper is government-run, government-backed. Now, the Malaysian Bar Council has confirmed to us they believe this whole scheme is not supported by the Malaysian Immigration Act. A senior justice official has also confirmed that to us. And in the last hour, I spoke to the opposition leader, Anwar Ibrahim. He indicated he plans to strenuously object to this whole scheme when Parliament next sits.
Well, they're obviously questioning the legality of the whole idea. Any reaction from the Australian government at this point?
Yeah, the Australian government, the minister's office told me a short time ago that because the deal isn't ultimately signed off on, they couldn't provide any further detail. Interestingly, though, they acknowledged to me that of the 800 asylum seekers to be sent here, they may not all be able to stay in Malaysia. The UNHCR might determine they're not legitimate refugees, so they could in fact be sent to their country of origin. There's plenty more detail on this story, George. We're putting that on our website right now, so you can go there for more detail if you're interested.
Hamish, thanks for that. Well done.